don't really need any deep sleep. I just wanna feel weak when I feel weak. Let me be me, let me speak up. Let me be free, let me reach peak. 1, 2, 3 times over, mind over matter. I won't be told, won't be thrown. They will know, standing on the shoulders of giants. I am defiant, I am bold, I'm lying. I'm on break, I'm on fire.
I am MVG.
Won't take no for an answer anymore.
I am the MVP.
Green light, one life, go faster. Any thoughts?
I am the champion. I am the man to beat.
I'm on fire.
And Michael Van Gerwen proves he is the best player on planet darts.
I'm on fire. Hello and a very warm welcome back to the Sydney West Dublin. And a very special welcome to our viewers joining us live on Sky Sports as we continue to bring you the very best in dance action. And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's meet the quarterfinalists. Firstly, from Australia, a two-time world finalist and a former European champion, ladies and gentlemen, the Wizard, Cypher.
Said he's got it. Star quality, panache, the X factor.
Yeah, people want to watch him, and he's got the game. We know that he's got this watchability, and the darting ability he's got is just incredible. Simon Whitlock knows that he's got to play kind of the perfect game. He's got to start well, score well, finish well. But what he's got to do things at the right time. If Michael does miss Simon's then got to put his foot on the gas and just put Michael under constant pressure every time he makes a mistake. And it's hard to do against someone that you know is going to hit you with a lot on any given day.
When he's under pressure, he just seems to have to put his foot on the accelerator and pull away.
He's just a champion, as is Simon. Simon can play so well, but against Alan Norris, he showed that as good as he can be, Simon, he did go off for two sets. He's going to have to play better and more consistent.
Dave Chisholm away to the winner of this one. John Parr, Nigel Pearce, new commentators.
96.
Thanks very much, Dave. Yes, and so good to see Simon Whitlock in the quarterfinals. A lot of people delighted to see him back on form with that wonderful, wonderful display.
No score.
Against Alan Norris, of course. 16 perfect darts, rounding the match off, edging through 3-2. And Whitlock has had his fine moments on the big stage, but plummeted. But now in this quarterfinal tie, but he knows the size of the task and he's not helping himself here.
No
score. Michael van Gerwen off and running at the very beginning.
Yeah, he certainly hasn't extended his perfect dart streak yet going into this match. He's perfectly missed six at double. The wrong kind of perfect. That's better. At least he can settle down. Not too likely to be catching up to Michael van Gerwen with that sort of a lead.
93.
Yes, it's setting up a fascinating semi-final. Dave Chisnell got the better of Daryl Gurney earlier, 3-1. But Simon is playing some nice darts in this tournament. 180. But the green machine kicking on here to set up a finish.
96.
Michael, who beat Steve Beaton 2-1, of course, survived a bit of a scare. And then James Wilson, 3-0. But we know what this man's capable
60.
Of.
60, Michael Yukon, 56.
And when he's on top form, he's good to watch. Tops for MVG. That's a lovely marker, isn't it? There you go, middle of the bed. And Michael van Gerwen gets us underway.
Second leg, Simon to throw first.
Well, it wasn't the best of legs for Michael, but because Simon took seven darts to get in, it was an easy win to start off.
71.
They'll both be looking to do better here, second leg.
First time of asking, here he goes. Smooth as you like. Made it look so easy there, Michael van Gerwen. Simon Whitlock, former world finalist, of course.
125.
Played beautifully last night. Under pressure. Twice winner of this tournament, 2012 and 2014. And runner-up last year, MVG, as well. As Wayne pointed out, Whitlock has to play consistently like he did towards the end of his game last night if he's going to get anywhere close to this fella. And then it's a question of whether van Gerwen slips and allows his opponent the opportunity to push him.
Well, yeah, and you bring up a good point, Nigel, in that last year Michael didn't win. Robert Thornton beat him in the final and he looked every bit as good last year as he does this year. So the point being, he can be beat. Anybody can be beat. We just have to put in the performance.
130.
Yeah, the final, of course, 5-4, Robert's favour. And now treble 19 for Simon. He's got two darts in hand, at double 80 needs, he's levelled it. Nicely done from Simon Whitlock. So Michael van Gerwen not having it all his own way. Early doors here, but what a way to start. What a way to start, John.
Well, he did start the last leg with that. Although he went first this time. Different kettle of fish.
Indeed, there is the difference.
30.
Switch across to 15s. Took us a bit by surprise there.
100.
Good atmosphere. see here at the City West in Dublin tonight. Fine lineup. Lovely switch to Trouble 18. Fans are absolutely loving this tonight, and it's going to be even busier tomorrow for the semi-finals as well. And then the final on Saturday. I can also tell you that the Republic of Ireland have just scored against Georgia. So, word spreading. Now, tens for Michael Van Gerwen.
Yeah, he got the double too early there. He's trying to, I think, get a good marker. He was going for a 12 dart leg. He did have a chance for it. Didn't need it.
20.
So, double 10 this time for MVG, no problem. First time of asking.
Michael Van Gerwen
holding his throw in this first set. Pressure back on Simon Whitlock, and MVG averaging a ton plus already. There you go, 100.95.
No score.
Simon is not away, so if Michael hits tops for the first dart, he's off and running.
Just about three consecutive legs of a 160 start, but he'll take 120, especially after Simon Nutt getting in.
Yes, won the throw back effectively.
30.
Double 15 working again for Simon, but too little too late perhaps.
You see the massive discrepancy in the averages. Although Simon has managed to take a leg.
They love the darts, they love 60. The front ball as well, especially when the Republic of Ireland take take the lead against Georgia. Elsewhere in Dublin tonight. Now this would be some party piece for Michael Van Gerwen. Treble 16 would have left double 12.
82.
He's got all the time in the world here, John.
Yeah, and he probably went that way for no other reason than it would lead to the tops if he did exactly what he did.
Whitlock probably knows the set is gone from here. Tops for Van Gerwen. Double 10 he needs. Nice marker. Well, he's going to be back anyway, but he'll be a little bit annoyed that he hasn't taken it out already.
Yeah, he'd be off the stage by now.
134.
I don't think Simon's all that pleased about circumstances.
He was making a hash of this, and Michael Van Gerwen, and a double five worked for him, but seven missed darts at a double at the finish in the first set, but he still takes it, and Michael Van Gerwen takes a one set lead. Whitlock really needs to dig deep here. Taken a first set of the match against Simon Whitlock. He did concede a leg, but he did enough, and he's averaging 95.8. Dave Chisnell, first semi-finalist confirmed, with a 3-1 win against Daryl Gurney, and Raymond van Barneveld at his vintage best, 3-0 against Van der Pas. Van Gerwen leads Whitlock 1-0, and still to come, Gary Anderson and Kim Huybrechts. That'll be fast. It'll be a good pace. It'll be good to watch, that's for sure. Now, second set of this one, race to three. And Simon Whitlock, who's enjoyed a good week here in Dublin. He won Players' Championship 18 on Sunday. Beat Ronnie Huybrechts. Beat MVG along the way, but it's a different story on the big stage here at the City West. Can he take some encouragement, though, John, that he did actually take a leg in that first set?
57.
I don't think he can the encouragement from the leg one, but I think where he can look to improve is he didn't play his best. You know, he's played some sets in this championship that are unbelievable. 112 average in the first set of his last match, and those 16 perfect darts. So he knows he can do it, and that's where he can have some faith and hang in there until he comes alive.
Winner of this will face Dave Chisnall in the semi-finals tomorrow night. The other semi-final will be Raymond van Barneveld against Gary Anderson or Kim Huybrechts. Cracking lineup for the semi-finals tomorrow, live on Sky Sports from 7 o'clock. Make sure you join us for that. Went for the ball with the last dart, so Whitlock with an opportunity for a holder throw to take the lead in the second set.
And we love 64. Even if you hit a 70, it's 17 for tops. And there it is. So 64, this is such an easy out to work with in any eventuality. But Michael straight back in.
160.
That's third, 160 in.
Whitlock matches it as well. Tell you what, that was a nice finish from Simon, because Van Gerwen was waiting to pounce right behind him. Here we go. Here we go.
171.
Brilliant from Van Gerwen. It's still on.
Well, could there be a better way of doing this nine dart leg than a 170 60. Finish?
He wants it. He wants it. Not going to get it. Got to focus on winning the leg now. Well ahead.
Well, now Simon can hit 170 to leave 170 and hope he gets a chance.
He can.
140. Michael Maguire, 86.
It's treble 18. Double four. He's left four,
and
leaving such a small number. Simon, not on a finish, knows though that if he gets a good turn, he can put pressure on.
And his double attempts, Van Gerwen, 27%. Whitlock's taken out two out of two. Well, he went for it. Slight deflection off the barrel. Double two. These are never easy, but he makes it look easy, doesn't he? So he levels the second set. It's going with the throw so far.
Game on.
Whitlock hanging on in there, still hoping that he can take this second set with a throw.
And he's doing better in since he's opted to start on the tops in this set.
120.
Simon, well, you're always going to be under pressure playing Michael. He knows he needs two or three travels a turn to guarantee himself first opportunity.
140.
Brilliant starting from Van Gerwen, but the finishing not so good. Hasn't really had to handle too much pressure when he has missed the double.
140.
Nice from Simon. He's doing okay here.
140.
Well, that 140 answer puts him to 101.
161.
Which pretty much needs, I mean, Simon must try and get this 161. Treble 18 would lead ball. Not the conventional way, but a ways away. Point is, he missed two trebles.
Well, how much would this hurt? Treble 19 would leave double 12.
77.
Well, well,
so
well.
61.
Did he rush it? Did he snatch it?
Well, he's been a little iffy on his doubles. There's something for Simon to work with. Hits the 50, only wanted 25, double four, and it's there. Great pressure shot.
He's playing nicely, Simon Whitlock. Holding his throw.
And he's building his confidence.
40.
He is. despite Van Gerwen's dominance at the starting double, Whitlock is hanging on in there. He can win this set.
Well, when you see your opponent missing darts at double out, you start to believe you have the better chance to win, because you're hitting your doubles.
Whitlock has not missed a dart at a double finish. All three legs he's taken have been at the first attempt.
The only worrying aspect about that is that he has only had the three attempts, and so he's being outscored pretty comprehensively in most cases.
Yes, of course, totally agree, but when the pressure's on, he's hit it.
Yeah, we always say you can't afford to miss 91. Those opportunities against the world number one, and well, he hasn't, so he's in here with a chance. Looking good to perhaps be up or be level 1-1.
Simon Uruguay 170.
Needs a treble 20. Okay, so
92.
Whitlock sitting on 65. Can Van Gerwen take this out? Gets a treble, needs double 16. There he goes, levels it. He levels it. Brilliant from Van Gerwen. And now Whitlock has to get away quickly, you feel, with the throw.
Yeah, just loads of pressure on this.
60.
It's not must win, but you feel like it is.
Well, if you go two sets down against this fella, you're in deep trouble. But it's a first of three. Van Gerwen's away. Whitlock needs a treble.
130.
Brilliant switch for treble 19, John.
Yeah, he's really putting in a gritty effort here. Try and get a set.
60.
Great chance for Simon from here to level it at one set all. Great first start. Third up, or is he going to switch? Yes.
137.
And once again, 170 is left.
134. Simon Uruguay, 170.
Another one of those would leave the ball.
105.
Now, Van Gerwen looking to put some pressure on. Could be on the verge of losing a set here.
139.
3-0 winner against James Wilson, but of course he did concede that set against Steve Beaton. Big moment for Simon Whitlock now. Seven would leave double four. Double six now. He's not totally happy, but what a finish, and he takes the set. Simon Whitlock playing nicely. He has not missed a dart and a double out. Four out of four. It's level, one set all, Van Gerwen and Whitlock. And there's more in a few moments' time. Commentary, how do you sum it up from here, John? What are your thoughts?
Well, Simon's confidence is building as we go, and Michael is more and more questions. So we have a good match going now. It looked a little iffy at the first set because Simon was going in on the 16s and then the 15s and back and around, and looked a bit of a mess. But when he switched in the second set to tops for his ins, he settled himself down, and sure enough, he won a set.
There you go, Michael Van Gerwen, his second 180 in a match. Good time to do it as well. Never a bad time, but in the context of the match. Perfectly timed from MVG. He holds his throw in this set, it'll be 2-1 up. Pressure back on Whitlock, but Whitlock starting nicely as well now.
139.
He's finished at 4 out of 4. Just doubles out, no problem there. He's had to, but by the same token, he's starting well now as well. Look at this.
Well, they needed a 180 to leave a finish. And Michael on 82, that'll be bull first dart if he can. No, so bit of a mess of it, but he's left tops in the end. He almost missed the 18, the third dart. Getting a little careless. Is that pressure or confidence? Not sure.
Yeah, Whitlock knows this leg is probably gone now. Van Gerwen, can he take out it? 13 darts, yes he can. So Van Gerwen takes the first leg of this third set. Now, can Whitlock get away first time?
Yeah, and that's where if Simon doesn't hold his throw here, this set can go very quickly against him. You see Michael averaging 103 in a double in format. Entirely impressive. Simon at 91. Well, that's a pretty good standard as well, especially with some of the missed ins he had in the first set.
Very much so. He's certainly picked up the pace where that's concerned. Nice 140 from Michael Van Gerwen. So 11 out of 17 for MVG.
Well, look at that. 11 for 29 Whitlock. So that means he's got a 91 average and he's at 18 darts. Six whole turns that didn't count for anything. Just to start.
140.
And Van Gerwen keeping the pressure on because he's first to a finish. Whitlock on 179.
Yeah, he should be better off though, even with three singles. He's thinking, I'm going to get a chance.
And the way he's finishing as well, John, he should feel confident, unless. So,
86. Simon, you
can take this out in two darts. If he hits the treble first. No margin for error now, Simon. Well, this could be a key moment.
Yeah, you want to miss high or low, not to the left or right on that 80 shot. It's two darts for double top. He only needs one, and he has a 2-0 lead. And the throw.
Third leg, Michael, if you throw first. Game on.
It's just a huge, huge task now for Simon to even think about trying to take this set, especially after Michael in the first dart.
80.
Yep, all Van Gerwen has to do is hold his throw. Sounds simple, but he's away first time. Now, can Whitlock just put a bit of pressure on? Again, that switch for double 18 works nicely in a lovely treble 20. But Van Gerwen away with the first visit. Another one of those that do nicely, right on cue.
Yeah, I think the fight has got out of Simon a little bit, but not for the match. It's probably this set, you know. No point wasting energy to fight an impossible battle when you don't need to.
A 180 would be nice, though, wouldn't it? Well, it's not going to get it. But even so, psychologically, John, you go 2-1 down against this fella. Do you realistically have an opportunity to win two sets on the trot and turn it around? It's a more than a tall order.
Well, he's already held his throw in the second set, and so he believes he could do that in the next set. You know, win or lose this set, he believes that.
140.
These are tough.
137.
So he can take that out. Now. An opportunity for Whitlock.
Well, yeah, Michael been a little bit sloppy in the leg, taking it for granted. And now Simon with two darts for tops, only needs one. Gets a break of throw, so he has to throw now.
For Blake Simon to throw first.
Still an awful lot to do, though.
It is, but he's scrapping for survival, and Van Gerwen will be annoyed. And Whitlock's away with the throw. Beautifully done from Simon Whitlock.
Oh, that is wonderful.
100.
He even got Michael to miss a dart. Just one.
Van Gerwen knows he's got a fight on his hands here.
59.
Yeah, he needed better than that, you feel. Not very 42. Good. Surprising, no punishment. Now the chance for Simon to do that.
Happens to the best.
94.
But Van Gerwen loses this leg. He's got the throw in the next. But you do wonder, 96. Any slip-up, if Whitlock can take it.
Well, yeah. Okay, Michael, he doesn't want to go to a next leg where he has the throw to win the set, because he'd be under the pressure that if he loses it, he's actually behind in the match 2-1. So that is not something he wants at all. He wants to win this leg.
Precarious. That's a nice first dart. This is better from MVG.
133.
Oh, and it's his turn to leave 100.
Trouble 20 would give him the bull. One dart for the bull. To level the third set. Brilliant! Brilliant! Brilliant!
Simon Whitlock.
Over to you, MVG! This game is on a knife edge now!
And oh, the beauty of the double in. Just to add to the tension. Michael switches to get the second dart in double 18. He's off, but it wasn't that big. A semi-chance here for Simon Whitlock.
Oh.
36.
Well, he's away. That's most important.
Yeah, that makes all the difference, really.
Oh, here we go. Here we go! What a response from MVG!
Yeah, almost to say, is that, what, you thought there was a problem?
Never in doubt. You've got to give Whitlock great, great credit. He's playing beautifully here, pushing Michael Van Gerwen every step of the way, and he 60. Can't find a treble.
Now Simon needs three trebles, big scoring ones to leave a finish.
43.
Some game this one. That might be the visit that costs him, though. First of three sets goes through to the semi-final. Van Gerwen knows he's in a bruising battle here.
168.
Oh, wasn't the best of shots, was it?
Well, he hit the wrong treble, really. He wanted treble 16 the last dart to lead tops.
4-180s for Simon Whitlock. He won't go away. Now. Five, two darts in hand for double 16. Look what it means to him. That is a sign of a man who knows that his opponent is playing well. 2-1 Van Gerwen.
Simon to throw first. Game on.
Yeah, he made a counting mistake, but no mistake at the double.
Well, he needs it.
No score.
He's not away. Now, if Van Gerwen can hit tops for the first dart. Oh, he could be looking at a break and throw in the first leg of this set. Whitlock has to hit the double.
96.
Not bad, considering he missed his first four.
45.
Still annoyed, Michael Van Gerwen. Start of the fourth set. First to three, remember. Nice from Simon Whitlock. Even better from Simon Whitlock. Fifth 180, not quite.
140.
Scrapping away.
Well, he has stuck his head out in front again, though. Just briefly. Very briefly.
140.
Van Gerwen averaging 103. Whitlock 93. This is a great, great quality showdown.
133.
Between the number one Van Gerwen and a man in form, a rejuvenated Simon Whitlock.
Yeah, who's going to have the pleasure of trying to go for that tasty 1-3-2 outshot with the Bulls.
He's done a 1-3-0 and he's done a 100. Another one would set it up nicely. Great effort.
92.
Now double eight for Van Gerwen for a break of throw. This is huge. Middle of the bend, first attempt, clinical, Michael Van Gerwen.
Second leg, Michael, to throw first. Game on.
Yes, Michael, in full control, you feel.
96.
A good open.
96, without scoring in the first. Very good. Well,
36.
Doubles away are starting to let Whitlock down a little bit, John. He's been magnificent for the majority. Lovely 140 from MVG. His body language says everything.
Well, he can sense the kill now. If he holds his throw here, he'll be attacking Simon's throw mightily. I don't think he's going to settle for knowing he has the throw in the leg after that. He wants to win this set 3-0, Michael.
Yeah, he's not that type of player, is he? Wants it done sooner rather than later.
34.
Nine darts for Van Gerwen so far. How he would love a 12-dart leg to go within one of the match.
100,
Whitlock's annoyed. Slack first start. And the second one.
Well, he should stay at the bottom, 119, at least if he only got a single, he'll leave 100.
69.
62. A little messy, still well ahead.
Tidied it up with the last start, though. A reminder, Dave Chisnell will face the winner of this.
62.
We know that Van Barneveld is one semi-finalist to face Anderson or Huybrechts. Double 16 for Michael Van Gerwen. Gets there. Two legs up, one within the match now. Simon Whitlock has played quite beautifully. But now he has to hold his throw, and he's away first time.
Well, he has to get away. He has to score well, and he has. He scored over 100. That's what he needed to do.
60.
Van Gerwen will want it done here.
Yeah, and Simon knows that. He knows that Michael's pushing right now to put him out here and now.
180 at Van Gerwen nicely just now.
76.
And he made a good start but wasn't able to follow it up. Still averaging 102. 3-180 so far for Michael, 4 to this fella.
He lost his focus the third dart. He didn't even really give it an honest effort because he was mad about hitting the treble five the second dart. You want to throw all three, Michael. And there he adjusts well to adversity. Came back in strong.
Still got a fancy Whitlock for the leg from here.
100.
And a vital, vital treble, the last dart. Michael looking for the 140 or the 180. And there's some real pressure.
Oh, just a bit. Whitlock is now throwing to save this match. 8-180s, four apiece. He's hit the treble 20. Two darts in hand for double 12 to save the match. Oh, no.
Oh. No finish available.
Oh,
72. Michael, you require.
Is that the moment that sees Simon Whitlock exit the World Grand Prix? 1-8 for the match.
54.
Well, Simon, very
Simon
fortunate.
He's
double six to keep alive, and he might be able to build off of it.
Didn't waste in that time. He's hanging on in there, John.
Well, yeah. It's something to build off of because Michael will be furious at himself for not wrapping it up then and there.
Oh, here we go, here we go, what a response! You just had a feeling, didn't you?
Well, the fury worked in his favour, as it often does.
Switch for double 18 now. How many times have we seen that 56. Work for him? Well, he could have been off the stage by now, but you've got to give Whitlock great credit.
140.
It's going Van Gerwen's way here in this leg now with the throw. But for the wizard, Simon Whitlock, if this is going to be the end, he can leave this competition with his head held high. Hugely popular player, a lot of fans delighted to see him back on the big stage and playing well.
60.
Only 60 though.
Yeah, well, I think Simon's, you know, he only got tripped up in this match and by having the starting problems in that first set. That was the only real difference. Still not
85.
Done yet, but
if
this gets wrapped up here and now, that's what Simon can look back at.
83.
Brilliant last start, wasn't it? So
Whitlock, he's battled very well. He's, you're right, he can hold his head high on this, but he just put himself in a bad spot by the troubles he had in that first set.
81. He's won a Players' Championship and he's reached the quarterfinal of the Grand Prix. Van Gerwen now needs tops, and no mistake that time. He knows though, he survived a bit of a scare along the way. Van Gerwen has been pushed hard by Whitlock. But MVG will face Chizzy, Dave Chisnell, in Friday night's semi-final. Great game from both players, good to see. And we have one quarter-final remaining, and what a match it promises to be. It's Kim Huybrechts and Gary Anderson